G'day, Chris from the Headache and Pain Management Centre, and today we're talking about headaches, migraines, cluster headaches. What is the common link that links all of them together? If you're joining us, please type in below and say hello. If you're on YouTube, you can type in the comments. If you're on Facebook, you can ask us a question. We're here to answer your questions. Now, today we are talking about the underlying mechanisms of headache and migraine conditions. Okay. There's been a lot of new research that's been done. There's a lot more that's been done, particularly over the last 10 years. And what you might hear today might shock you a little bit, because this information, I guess, is for people that have tried the medications, hasn't quite worked. They've tried their triggers. They've tried to eliminate things out of their diet. They've drunk more water. They're getting more sleep, but it's just not quite getting to where it needs to get to. So today, this video is for you. Now, the first thing to understand is how a headache and migraine actually starts to happen in your body and in your brain. Now, to understand that, there needs to be a bit of an understanding of what the anatomy is like in the top of the neck and bottom of your brain. So this here is a nice model. Okay, we just bought it, still got a sticker on it. So what we've got is we've got your neck. That's the back of your neck. That's your skull. And up the middle of your neck comes your spinal cord. At the top of your spinal cord, it turns into the bottom of your brain, or what we call the brain stem. Okay, so in that area at the bottom of your brain, top of your neck, there's a special area in there that takes in all of the nerve input practically from the top lip. So if you drew a line just across here, up and over to the top three joints of your neck. Okay, so all of those nerves from your head, your neck, your face, your jaw, your tongue, teeth and lips, a bit from your ears as well. Actually, there's a muscle that attaches up into there as well. And also the nerve that supplies your fight or flight response, okay, called your vagus nerve. They all go into this special area at the bottom of your brain. So it's almost like they all come in into this hodgepodge of information, okay? It all gets melded together a little bit. That message is then put together, sent up towards your brain, and your brain needs to process it and go, well, what's going on with that? Okay, where is this signal coming from and what does it all mean? Okay, and for people that have headache and migraine conditions, the person's brain decides that it's time for a headache or it's time for a migraine. So what does that mean for people that get headaches and migraines quite frequently, quite commonly? Well, here's what it means. What it means is that part at the bottom of the brain, the link that combines, I guess, all of the headache and migraine conditions together, okay, the mechanism is what we call a sensitized brainstem, a sensitized trigeminocervical nucleus, for those nerds that might want to know the really long word for it. We call it the headache hub here at the clinic, okay? So what it means when it's sensitized is that normal information that passes through that area, okay, so the normal movement of your joints, the normal coming and going of the hormones during a menstrual cycle, the normal feeling of thirst or hunger, the normal feelings of a little bit of fatigue and so forth, start to be listened to by your brain and amplified by heaps, okay? So your brain thinks that there's a really huge problem, but as a matter of fact, there's not a really huge problem. There's a small problem that's been amplified by this very sensitized structure in the bottom of your brain, and it causes your headache and your migraine to start. And then, of course, if you're getting them a lot, it's like it's a habit. It just keeps going and going and going and going from there. So for those people that have tried the medications, that have tried the Imigrans, that have tried the triptan groups, the Panadols, all of these sorts of drug therapies, and they haven't quite worked, what we need to look at is the top of the neck as the next port of call, okay? The reason why is because the top of the neck, as I said before, the top three joints of the neck, C3, 2, and 1, all the joints, the discs, and the muscles and ligaments that attach to it, have these input into the top of the brain. So what it means is that that input goes in, the brain listens to it, amplifies it, and whooshka, we've got a headache or a migraine. And so if you've got a stiff neck, a stiff joint at top of the neck, something that's not quite going right with the top of your neck, your brain perceives that as a bigger threat than what it needs to be. So for some people, a bit of a stiff neck just feels like a bit of a stiff neck. You give it a bit of a rub, you know, a bit of heat on it, and it feels okay. But for some other people, that stiff neck can amplify you know, 10x, 100x to turn into like a whopping great big migraine with vomiting, with nausea, with dizziness, sensitive to light and sound, all the bells and whistles that can come from it, all as a result of that sensitized system being sensitized by the ongoing input coming from the top of the neck. It's really quite an amazing thing to witness if you've never seen it before. This is what my career's been dedicated to, frankly, for the last 15 years since I graduated from uni. Headache and migraine has been kind of my special little baby. And since I came across these techniques a number of years ago, and then nerding up for the next 10 to 15 years, reading all the textbooks, doing all the courses, and seeing thousands of patients here at the Headache and Pain Management Center, that is the prime suspect if things aren't going quite right for you. So if you've never had your neck skillfully assessed by somebody who knows what they're talking about with headache and migraine, that are able to assess very carefully what's going on at the top of your neck, then it's time to do so, because life's short. It's not worth living with headache and migraine if there's something that can be done about it. Do I make promises I can't keep? No, I can't. But what we're looking to do is to look and see if we can rule in or rule out the neck as being a cause for your headache and migraine, okay? So if that's you, please get in touch with us. Click on the link above, send a comment below, and we can help you out, okay? Hope that's been really helpful. It's just a short one today. If there's any questions, please let us know, but otherwise, we'll see you again next time. Cheers, and bye for now.